guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I have created this super gorgeous peachy glittery eyes paired with nude lips, perfect for this festive season. And you can wear it with a number of your outfits, with your traditional outfits like saris, anarkali suits, salwar suits, and it will actually make you look really pretty. It's such a wearable soft makeup look which you can actually create very easily. You can actually change the pair of earrings according to your liking, and I hope you're gonna like it. Make sure you subscribe and let's get started with the video. So as usual, I have moisturized my face using my favorite moisturizer. This is the Sugandha White Lotus Moisturizer, perfect for my acne-prone combination skin. Now it's time to move on to the brows. I'm taking a spoolie and brushing it through my brows to give it a really nice shape. Now for the brows, the first product which I'm using is this one. This is the Faces Canada All-Time Pro Brow Defining Pencil in the shade brown. And I basically use this product on a regular basis, guys, because it's very long-lasting. And with this product, you can actually draw your brows really well, and the shade actually goes really well with Indian brows. I'm just outlining my brow, at the same time fill it in using the same product. Using a spoolie, I'm distributing it all over my brow and doing the same thing on my left eyebrow as well. Now I'm taking this Nykaa Take a Brow Eyebrow Filling Powder, which is basically a setting powder for your brows, and I'm just putting it in the middle of my brow, and whatever product is left in the brush, I'm just distributing it in the front. And this actually sets my brow really well, and my brows look really bold because it's a festive makeup look and you want your brows to look really bold and nice. Using a concealer, I'm just cleaning out the edges so that my brows look really prominent, and it adds a very nice lift to your brows. But make sure that you just blend the concealer or the foundation you're putting surrounding your brows really well. And you can see now for the primer, I'm using this very affordable Blue Heaven primer, which is basically a silicone primer, helps in just smoothing your face really well. It doesn't do very much for my pores, but makeup sits really well on top of this primer. So if you want to try an affordable option, you can give this one a shot. For the foundation, I'm using Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the shade 230 Reach Tan. I'm just applying it all over my face with the help of my fingers. Now I'm taking this Plume Celestial sponge to blend out my foundation, and you can see it's a medium coverage foundation, but it's a really good affordable foundation if you want to try under budget. And you know, it's favorite for all guys, and everyone just love this foundation, and it has definitely helped in covering my blemishes and dark spots really well. Now I'm taking my PAC Spotlight Ready Concealer in the shade Nutcracker, and I'm just putting it under my eyes, on my eyelids, on my nose, and also blending the same using the same sponge. And this is my all-time favorite concealer because it sets so well. It gives my face such an uplifted look, and it's a complete smudge-proof, budge-proof concealer. And for this festive season, if you want a really long-lasting concealer, this is for you. Now to set my concealer, I'm using this Fit Me Finishing Loose Powder in the shade 20 Light Medium. At first, I'm just setting my under eyes with the help of this product. Then whatever is left in the brush, I'm just dusting it all over my face to set my overall face. And you know, this just filters my face, and it's my favorite loose powder of all time, and I highly recommend you guys to try this one. Now it's time to move on to the eyes. So for the eyes, I'm using ColourPop Yes Please Cute AF Palette, which used to be one of my favorites. At first, I'm taking this rusty orange shade from the palette in a fluffy blending brush. I'm going to apply it all over my crease and slowly build up the color on my crease and blend it really nicely. The brush here I am using is from Pro Arte, and you just need to blend it really well. You can use a light brown shade for this purpose as well. Now I'm taking this red shade, which is having brick undertone, and with the help of a tapered blending brush, I'm putting it in the outer two-thirds of my eyes and just dragging it towards my crease and blend it really nicely. This will help in creating a nice gradient. Now I'm taking this dark chocolate brown shade from the palette in a small crease brush. I'm just applying it in the outer corner of my eyes to add a nice depth to my eyes and blending it really well with the previous shade which I have put there on. Now taking my previous tapered blending brush, I'm going to blend out the edges so that everything looks really diffuse and there is no harsh lines. You just need to blend your eyeshadow really well, guys, to get a perfect look. Now I'm taking this glittery, basically shimmery peach shade from the palette and spraying a little bit of fixer on it to get the best pigmentation. I'm just applying it all over my lid as my lid shade. Here you can actually just do a cut crease effect as well using a concealer, but I have found that this shade works really well on its own. I don't have to put concealer beneath this, so I'm just applying it directly all over my lid. Taking that rusty brown shade again, I'm just running it all over my lower lash line to add a nice warmth to my lower lash line. Now this is the star of the show. It's the Glitter Mafia pressed glitter in the shade Rose Gold. And look at this. This looks so stunning, guys. You don't need a separate glitter glue with this glitter. You can actually just directly apply it on your lid. And I'm just applying it on top of my lid on the previous shade, which I have applied all over my lid. And you can see it has completely changed the game. Now I'm taking this Faces Ultime Pro Intense Gel Kajal and tightlining my upper waterline as well as my lower waterline with it. I'm thickly applying it on my lower lash line because I'm going to smudge it using this dark chocolate brown shade. I'm just smudging out the coal to make it look really smokier, really dramatic, because it just makes me look good. Now I'm taking this Color Bar liquid waterproof liner, which is my current favorite, guys, because it's a matte liquid liner and it's really affordable. So you can definitely give this one a shot. And with this applicator, you can actually draw your winged eyeliner really, really well. And I'm really liking it. You can see it is completely 100% matte liquid liner. Now I'm taking this champagne golden shade from the palette, and with the help of a small pencil brush, I'm just applying it in the inner corner of my eyes to just highlight my inner corner, and also gonna apply it on my brow bone to highlight my brow bone. Using a blending brush, I'm going to blend out the edges so that everything looks really nice and diffuse. Now I'm taking this PAC Double Volume Volumizing Mascara, which is also my favorite, guys, because it separates my lashes so well. It adds such a nice lift to my lashes, and your lashes actually are visible after you apply this mascara, and within a minute you're gonna see the result, how gorgeous this looks on your lashes. I'm just applying it on my lower lashes as well, and this works so well, guys. This applicator is really great and I really like it. You can see mascara makes a lot of difference to your eye look, guys. I'm using this pair of falsies from Bay Beauty, and you can see I have applied this a false eyelash, and this is my final eye look. So I'm just dusting off all the glitters which are scattered randomly all over my face with the help of this powder brush. And these are not stubborn glitters, guys. You can actually work with it. Now it's time to add some warmth to my face, for which I'm using Maybelline Master Contour Palette. And I'm gonna at first take this contouring shade and apply it under my cheekbones, on my jawline, on my forehead, on the areas where I just need to add those artificial shadows to make my face look really slimmer and structured. I'm also going to contour my nose as well so that my nose looks much more sharper and structured. And this product actually blends really well, guys, and the shade actually goes really well with Indian skin tones. You can definitely try it. Using the blush from the same palette, I'm going to apply it on the apples of my face, and this is basically a shimmery blush which adds a lot of glow to your cheeks as well. So you can definitely try it for your festive looks. I'm also applying it on my nose to add a flush of color on my nose as well, and you can see it looks really, really pretty. For the highlighter, I'm using my all-time favorite Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter in the shade Molten Gold. And guys, if you want to try one single highlighter which is from drugstore, which actually looks really gorgeous on your face, you just need to try this one because it looks so glowy. The formula is amazing. It looks really wet on the face, which I really like. I'm adding it on the high spots of my face, on my cheekbones, on my nose, cupid's bow, chin, and you can see the final result. It looks so glowy and I absolutely love this highlighter, guys. Now it's time to move on to the lips. I am just neutralizing my lips using the sponge, adding the highlighter on my cupid's bow. For the lipstick, I'm using Sugar Nothing Else Matter longwear lipstick in the shade Rose Job, which is basically a gorgeous dusty rose nude shade having peach undertones. And if you belong to fair to medium to British skin tones, this nude lip color will definitely go with any of your looks, but if you belong to deep to dusky skin category, you can put a brown lip liner underneath this and apply this lip color. The formula is really good, guys. It's very comfortable to wear. I just absolutely love this Range by Sugar, and you can see it is looking really gorgeous with this eye look. Now to set my face, I'm using Swiss Beauty a makeup fixer, which has got a very bad chemically scent, yet this makeup fixer actually sets my makeup really well. And I'm adding a black bindi because I like to wear black bindi with my traditional outfits. Adding these a pair of jhumkis which I got from Voila, and these are of really really good quality, guys, and I really love wearing jhumkis. So this is a finished look. So this is a finished look, guys. This is how it turned out, and I'm really happy with the final result. I'll be bringing a lot more makeup tutorials for this festive season, so please stay tuned for that. And if you like it, make sure you hit on the like button and subscribe to my channel for getting more of these videos. We'll see you soon. Until then, take care of yourself, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye, guys.